Okay, here we are. Actually, given that all I'm doing for the next section is travelling, there's going to be a lot of travelling. Pieces of equipment for Lynn, I think. Or not? This could be interesting then. That's not what I wanted to do. Frog time! Can we go through the forest? What about the water? No, okay. But I can go over cliffs for some reason. Some cliffs. Ah. This does enable me to do. Maybe. Let's take some shortcuts.
Yeah, okay.
Hello.
Discord. Hello. Discord is telling me my connection is terrible. And that's wrong, so whatever, Discord. Are you enjoying your time with Breath of Fire 2?
I kind of am, actually. Somewhat unexpectedly. It's very relaxing.
Yeah.
Except when you wander into something that you're underleveled for. But,
yeah.
Then it gets a bit dicey.
Then you wander back into stuff you're plenty prepared for, and then you're fine.
Yeah. Also, your first vehicle is the frog.
That is pretty good.
Yep. For some reason, the frog can traverse cliffs.
Well, look at the thing.
It's a pretty large frog. It is a pretty large frog.
And frogs are, you know, jumpy.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure a frog this large couldn't jump like this.
Well, you know fantasy animals.
Also, it's really inconsistent which trees it can and can't jump over. Sorry, he can and can't jump over. He is actually a character.
Oh.
Have you met the frog yet?
No, I stopped. Like I said, I kind of got caught up in Doom.
Yeah, I noticed that.
That real quick. Like I'm loading it up right now, just so I can get through the final level, beat the final boss, and like. Stop playing it because it's really good, but I need to actually work on Breath of Fire 2. I'm glad the frog can also cross lakes.
Yep. I might have screwed myself here though, because I also need the monkey because he can jump the gaps between cliffs.
He can use his stretchy arms, you mean?
On the one hand, I like that, but on the other hand, at the moment, it means using the two worst characters. Can you jump? Oh, you good. The frog can jump across the gap between cliffs. I don't need to go and get the monkey. I think the thing that strikes me as most odd is that they've got two completely different collision maps for the world, one for the frog and one for not the frog.
Well, I mean, if you're going to have a vehicle like that, you're going to have make sure everything interacts properly.
I guess.
It was SNES Capcom.
True. It just seems a little like a resource-intensive way of doing it, I suppose. I do really like all the combat sprites, though.
It's a weird angle, but it works most of the time.
The animations are really good as well. Particularly for when you consider how old the game is.
Yep.
No, I want to go into Capitan and take the boat. Because the frog can't cross the sea.
Where are you, stupid demon? There you are.
Frog also can't enter towns in giant form. Never mind.
I have killed all the large demons and now I'm just being harassed by imps. God damn it.
At least they're imps and not lost souls.
No, those are probably gonna spawn in too.
Things.
Those are fun though, because they scream at you before they charge you. You have plenty of warning.
Things I don't miss about the SNES era: NPCs you can't walk through that random walk down narrow passages in towns that you need to go through.
Yeah. I'd sure love that specific era of RPG. Figure that shit out. Like, fucking Tales of Phantasia, that fucking crab!
Oh my god, the crab! It was the worst. Now...
I can't believe I beat that crab.
I can't believe you beat that crab. How long did it take?
About 15 minutes.
Good grief.
Oh god, I'm being double-teamed by Barons of Hell. That's good. That's good. That's real good.
Sounds like fun.
I'm running away.
Can I now get into the prison from the actual frog town, or do I have to go through the sewers again?
Oh my god. God damn it, I need BFG ammo, I need that Chivo for killing two of them in one shot.
Gotta get them Chivos.
Fucking Cacodemon, nope!
Have you figured
everything
out?
Everything is happening so much.
Have you figured out fighting the Cacodemons yet?
Well, I've been fighting them for a while, but also I'm really low on health right now! And I don't want to get close to them because they chomp you. They just, like, carve an arc out of your entire torso and you're dead.
Nice. Yes, yes, I'm trying to save you in the sense that you're the thief I'm trying to capture. Stop fucking... Let me actually take a step! Oh my god!
I didn't even... Oh my god, I didn't even get to kill both of them! Somehow one of them died already! Fuck's sake! I can't get any of the Chivos! I'm too good at fighting! Oh god, that's an enormous just mound of pickups. Holy shit, I need to tweet that. Ugh. Oh my god.
Right. Did I see? Oh my god. So a double wide door. Both tiles are load zone.
Oh my god.
But the game doesn't.
I just saw that.
The game doesn't deactivate the load zone for the tile you're not on when you come through it. Ugh.
That is some old school garbage.
Yep.
That's some RPG Maker garbage.
Well, this is kind of exactly where RPG Maker got it from, I suppose.
Yeah.
And now, I get to do that exact same journey entirely in reverse. Because that's how this game works. After every chapter, you go back to your hometown. Which for the most part I like, kind of as a formal thing, but it does mean that there's a lot of backtracking in a game with a relatively high encounter rate.
Yeah, it seems like it would be... It's gonna get kind of grating to just revisit.
But, yeah. You know. My D-pad movement's improving, though. Getting a lot more precise.
Oh boy, all these wraiths of past Doom guys sending me off to jump into the belly of the beast. I just jumped down the skeleton's throat.
Nice.
This is the final boss battle.
That's some proper Doomin'.
You made a deal with the devil, lady. You're gonna get destroyed. Spider Mastermind time.
Ooh.
Oh, that is really cool looking.
Is that the Spider Mastermind?
Yep. Oh! Oh, good. Oh, good, it has melee moves. And I have to do jumping shit.
Man. Doom 2 was one of the first games I ever owned. I might still have the disc somewhere.
I have played a solid, like, one campaign of Doom ever. And it was just, like, knee deep in the dead, and I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. And then this came out, and I think it was actually because this came out that I played it. Oh, okay, I'm getting kind of owned.
Oh god, it's the orange balls. With the counterattack.
Wow, she's doing all sorts of crazy laser things.
Spider Masterminds do that.
Yep.
Well, okay, they don't in, like, old Doom, because mostly they just plasma gun you.
Oh my god, she's a reversible giant spider. And, oh wow, I just got fucked up.
Reversible in the sense of,
flip over and has different modes.
Okay, here's a problem. The frog moves two tiles at a time, and bridges are one tile wide.
Wow.
So if you're not in alignment with the bridge, you have to defrog. And refrog.
Electrify the floor. Or electrify the pillars that keep you off the floor. Okay, I'm learning this boss slowly. Whoa! fucking laser show.
Fun, fun, fun.
This is a really cool fight, but also I just got punched in the face by a spider. God.
Wait, I don't want to go here first. I don't want to go to, like, new hometown first. I want to go to old hometown first.
Oh my god.
Where?
Whoop. I got...
Oh, that's a shortcut and a half. I have to remember that. I'm disappointed this game doesn't have a recolor of the green slimes from the first enemy zone yet. Because they're cute.
I'm sure we'll see blue slime soon enough. Or red.
Probably. Okay, I'll go and inspect your basement for proof that you're a thief somehow.
Hello.
While robbing your mansion myself, because this is a JRPG, and it's okay when I rob mansions. Can't play the piano, minus 10 points.
What do you think this is, Final Fantasy V?
Bun whale. Bun whale, local specialty. I wonder if it's a quest item. I do like that they've made sure that every area has a toilet. Right, next task, go and collect Bosch. Which first requires getting out of this town.
Oh god, I'm low on health.
You're right.
Not really.
How are you, Sam? You there? Oh.
that like a response does not indicate as such.
He is, he's just muted and silenced. This game is trying to play it while you're asleep. Or tired, even. Which kind of leads to playing it while you're asleep. Also, I like that opening the, like, when you have opportunities to reform your party, they serve as inns as well. So you get a full heal. Osh! Now I think I need Bosch in my party. Ah, there you are. All right?
Yeah, I was just decided to get back onto Trails of Cold Steel because I played about 50 hours of that and hadn't finished it, so I spent the last hour going through the whole recap.
Ah.
Yeah, because it's at least it's one of those games that has all the story written in like a notes thing.
That's useful.
First thing I saw, I think the first time I've seen that was in a Tales game.
Symphony did that, yeah, and there's electricity. You're the BFG, fucker.
Oh, you're playing Doom?
Yep.
Oh, that game's so good.
It really is. I'm on the final boss.
I couldn't get on with most of the bosses. But I don't know. I suppose that's not the best thing to say while you're already playing the game.
Yeah. I mean, I like the bosses. I'm having a bit of trouble with this one, but that's just because it's the final boss.
Actually, no, there's one boss I did really like a lot. It was the when you had to fight the two warrior guys.
Yeah, the second phase of that one is really cool. Yeah. Oh boy.
I know. Yeah, that game is really fun.
Oh no, I can't use the chainsaw on the Spider Mastermind. 0 out of 10.
I don't actually know what I'm supposed to do here. I did look up a guide, but I've forgotten.
I haven't even touched any of Doom's multiplayer.
That's fine. Oh, come on, I got that health. God damn it. Right, since I'm in a boss, I should probably change my runes so we don't have, like, my usual setup.
Runes? What is this nonsense?
They're status effect or passives you can have on.
Yeah.
And they're good, I just have, like, the setup where I get better drops. And also I can do the melee kills faster. I should put on things like, pulling items from farther away.
One of the weirder things about Trails of Cold Steel was there was a character called Chancellor Osborne.
Really?
Yeah.
How timely. Well, actually not timely anymore, is it?
No.
Ha ha ha. Find pleasure where we can. I like how every banquet is the same four dishes. Set out in the exact same way as well.
The creatures of habit. And half of them are in front of empty chairs. But it is probably like the limitation of, well, we got four sprites, so we gotta put them somewhere.
Yeah.
We can fit, like,
I mean,
eight there or something.
They would have fit in a row down the middle of the table, but that wouldn't have been aligned with the grid.
Yeah. Grids. Just always feel weird to me.
Mm-hmm. And they're inevitable with this way of doing graphics. But.
Oh yeah. That's always one thing that sometimes annoys me is I get weird. I find grid movement really weird and a bit annoying.
It can be awkward, particularly with an Xbox D-pad.
Yeah.
Particularly with a loose Xbox D-pad that wobbles a lot.
I think if you move at a decent speed, I don't tend to have an issue with it, but there's a lot of RPG Maker games that move on a grid.
Well, yes. I mean,
you didn't let me finish the sentence before you went the well. Yes, I said in a way I don't like. But, yeah. Maybe I'm spoiled by analog movement.
Anyway. So. We accepted a mission to break into this house, and instead of having us walk there, this game that so far has had us walk absolutely fucking everywhere just teleported us across town. That old school inconsistency. Don't want to go to the loo.
I downloaded Pokemon Go today.
Oh?
That's now officially out in the UK.
Yep.
And it's drained half of my battery in half an hour.
Lol.
Which, with like full data, GPS, and Wi-Fi on and everything, usually lasts an entire day. So yeah. It is savage.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't catch shit. I got like a Charmander and a Pidgey, and that was it.
I'm so glad I'm not into Pokemon at all.
Oh my god, yes, this is the best glory kill.
Huh? Yep, it is the best glory kill.
Yank. This Spider Mastermind's mouth open and jam the BFG in.
I think I'm getting an encounter every step down here.
That's a joke I've seen in like several Newgrounds flashes.
Wait, Newgrounds flashes are still a thing?
No, I just remember watching them back in the day. In like 2004.
There's a bunch of people in prison down here.
Is Newgrounds still around? Are they still doing things?
I think it still exists.
ostensibly, Newgrounds exists.
But isn't the whole thing that they use Flash? Isn't Flash dying?
Maybe.
I'm pretty sure, like, Adobe was like, please stop using Flash. But that's not gonna stop people.
Okay, boss fight time.
Oh my fucking god, that ending. Oh my god.
Yep.
I can't wait for New Doom 2.
And what a surprise, this guy also turns into a demon. That's a good demon. I like that.
But that end of the ending to Doom is pretty much like that is a very much an I Want More ending, isn't it?
Yes. Holy shit.
And that one, like the Newgrounds Flash portal site, and then just like looking through like the top best of all time Flashes, and I don't recognize a single one of them.
Yeah, there was a time where I'd spent like a lot of time on Newgrounds, and it wasn't like watching all the popular stuff. It was watching like really dumb, like specific sub-community and like subcategory stuff. It was never super popular.
I watched a lot of the Under Judgment stuff.
Let's see what the level 2 dragon powers do. That's a slightly more convincing dragon. And it did 500 damage, which is twice as much as I've ever done in a single hit before.
Oh.
Nice.
I remember like watching through all the Under Judgment stuff, and most of them were terrible. Most of them were bad. And then I remember watching like Charlie the Unicorn when it was still Under Judgment.
Oh my god. Fucking Charlie the Unicorn.
When the day it had just come out for the first time, I was like, what the fuck is this?
Mm-hmm.
It was my brother watching, Sam, you gotta see this! And yeah, it's weird. And it lasted for several years of people making quotes of it.
Yep.
The top thing on Newgrounds is animation versus Minecraft.
Oh my god. Is that like an extension of the animation versus animator series? Somehow? Yeah. Because like, ugh.
There's another one. Flowey's transformation is on this. I remember like Bitey of Brackenwood and things like that. That's not on here. That used to always be at the top. I just love looking at some of the Under Judgment stuff. Maybe just look through the titles, like Final Fantasy Sonic X7 Intro.
What? I think the last good thing I saw on Newgrounds was the Sonic Shorts collections.
And even those have made like their way to YouTube with the animators, like just rendering out stuff. Like that Flash videos, putting it on YouTube. So,
this Final Fantasy Sonic X7 is. I wanted to make FFSX7. The real creator Black Devil X tried to make, but he cancelled it. He made from 1 to 6. So you should check out the user. I tried to make the game myself, but I decided to cancel it. So this is like a fan work of a fan work?
Blimey.
What I... Actually, the thing I remember most from fucking Newgrounds was Super Mario Bros. Z.
Oh, that's still on the... That's like number 6 on the best of all time.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. Oh,
I never watched that. Like, was that sprite animation or something?
Yeah, basically, and it was like surprisingly decent sprite animation combined with like general flash animation, and it was really dumb because it was basically like Mario and Sonic and Dragon Ball Z all mashed up into one, and it's just like, okay, calm down.
Hang on, this episode 1 is from 2016.
Okay, well, you better fucking link that somewhere in the, maybe in the stream chat. Because it's just us in here, and I need to see this.
Meanwhile, I'm in an honest-to-god cutscene. Just reminding me that I fought 4 demons now. And I got to see the cool Dragon's Eye animation again.
So far, it doesn't even load. This is in the top, like, 50 for the poll.
Oh, boy.
Apparently it's a revamp.
Ah. Ah, yes, the Super Mario Bros. Z Revival Project is now on Patreon!
And click it.
And it's been removed!
NPC, please move. Oh. She was actually here to talk to me.
Oh my god.
His Twitter's on there and he's still active on it.
And Colleen is following him. He sure is making $1,700 a month.
Yeesh.
What was the one I watched?
Oh my god. I just opened up his Patreon, because he has a different one that's specifically for his all of his stuff. And one of the first comments, or one of the comments on his latest post that's like, hey, I'm going to be doing this monthly instead of episode now, is, hey, I just became a patron and I would really like your help in making this awesome web series, and a link to Kingdom Hearts Fan and Wikia with Kingdom Hearts Superhero Keyblade Tyson.
Oh, good grief.
If you click it, you see the amazing logo. Which has totally not been made in MS Paint.
Superhero Keyblade Tyson, aka Superhero Keyblade Force, is a fan project taking is currently, like this is gonna change, a fan project taking place after the upcoming Kingdom Hearts 3. It is the first title in the Kingdom Hearts series not to feature Disney characters, but instead have characters from other Disney owned properties such as the Marvel Superheroes, and also characters from Capcom and toy properties, including Street Fighter, Mega Man, Super Sentai, and Kamen Rider.
Ooh. And
look at the name
of it. Underneath the English title, there's a Japanese title.
They have a kana title. I want to fucking put this into emoji. What does it say? Holy shit.
Okay. Characteristic genre name. What the fuck do we think we're doing? Characteristic genre name, there's no way we're getting permission for this. Characteristic genre name, hello lawyers!
The RPG that gets you sued. That string of katakana, I think, or hiragana under it. The kana under it says Superhiro Kiburedo Tyson.
Dang.
I would have half expected a Google Translate.
God.
Okay. How the hell do I get to the town called Gate? And why is a town called Gate, even in a fucking fan translation that's supposed to be good?
It's better. Which is...
Yeah, I've been...
Low bar.
I mean, I've been using a guide for the SNES version, clearly in the original translation, and it's hopeless. None of the names of anything makes sense.
Remember when they named the woodsman Baba? Instead of Bunyan, as they translated it, which was
I live near a city named Bath.
It's true. That's true. But British place names are ridiculous.
And so are things based off pseudo-British fantasy world. So.
And there are at least two towns in this country called Street.
Yep.
Oh, so now we have backstory, apparently. That was unexpected.
Maybe there's a Vita Gundam game coming out soon?
I think it's one of the garbage ones. Like, I remember a lot of people being like, yeah, it's coming out, but it's not going to be good. Which is unfortunate.
Oh. I'll just, like, maybe I'll get around to watching Gundam again.
Which Gundam?
I keep meaning to go back and watch the original again.
Dang.
I really liked it when I first watched it. But I'm probably going to watch it as the compilation movies.
I really wish Doom wasn't 50 gigabytes.
Yeesh.
That's enormous. Uh-huh. I want to just trim That's... off the multiplayer.
That's like,
but yeah, it's
just any disc-based game these days seems to be about 50 gigabytes.
Yeah, but it's still enormous, and I don't like having one game take up that much space. I guess I can,
I remember being surprised that, like, The Witcher 3 was only about 18 gigabytes, I think.
Blimey.
Yeah, that's a little shocking. Well, that's at least one more game added to my cleared category on Steam.
You hear that, Sam? You hear that? Finishing games.
I finished two games over the last few days.
Congratulations.
I beat Doom in 4 days, and I usually take, like, weeks to get around to beating shooters, but Doom is good.
I
beat two Disgaea games in the space of just over a month. That's pretty significant.
Yep.
Wow. I would have finished Doom a lot faster if I didn't have jumped the commute.
Yes, that's fair.
Yeah, I only had enough time. I mean, I've got slightly more time now, but when I was... playing it, I had about 45 minutes at a time to play it.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I just, like, wake up in the middle of the night and go, oh, it's time to play Doom. And then I got tired of Doom, so I played Dark Souls. It's like, okay, I'm tired of Dark Souls. I'm going back to Doom. That's how I beat the game. I got to Sense Fortress, and then I was like, I'm fine with, like, not playing the rest of this.
So you didn't like Sense Fortress?
Not really. Like,
you wouldn't like Dark Souls 2 then?
No, I'm playing Dark Souls 2 and I'm liking it a lot better.
It gets, I'd say, out of any of the areas in 1, there are a lot of places that are more like Sense Fortress in 2.
It wasn't that I didn't like Sense Fortress in particular, it was that all my gear was kind of low-ish. I had just been scraping by, and I didn't want to do the grind to get up to, like, passable.
Yeah, getting experience in 2 is really easy compared to the first one.
I basically, so far, I think I started, like, night before last, and I basically got, I got up to Old Dragon Slayer and Pursuer Knight, and I got a bit into the Huntsman Copse. So.
What did you think of the Pursuer?
He's a pain in the ass. I can parry him, like, 60% of the time.
Yeah, that's how I end up beating him.
Can't wait for the frog to stop being useful as a party member. Get me an actual boat, Blix.
One thing I really don't appreciate is, this would be in the manual probably, but, like, none of the special ability or, like, none of the characters' like unique abilities tell you what they do. It's just like,
yep.
Oh, you have to figure out that boss's thing is either he does 1 damage or he instantly kills the thing. Which is just like, if you want to gamble on that, sure, but I don't.
Yeah, I still don't know what most of the specials do. I know Ryu's is a heal based on amount of damage taken.
Yeah, the lower his HP, the higher chance he'll get a decent amount.
Nina's is a chance of restoring AP, which is useful, except that she never runs out of AP because she's got loads.
Yeah.
The really useful one is Rant, which is the free res.
Or free wake up.
Yeah, random chance of free res or wake up.
Yep. I think it's like 40% chance to res or something.
It's like a lot better than it could be, given how mean this game sometimes is.
Yeah. Basically, if at the point I'm at, if a character drops, I just kind of reload.
I hate these fucking poison bug things. At least that one went down easily.
Wow, that's a really good tagline on this game on Steam. Gravity Cat, it's a puzzle platform. You play as a cat who has an ability to change the gravity. That's it. That's the entire description.
Stick to your selling points, I suppose.
Turn off the lasers and avoid saws. Go through the levels from the simplest to incredibly difficult.
It sounds very, dry?
It sounds very Steam, to be honest.
Yeah. He's got training cards.
It has a really silly looking logo. Where the G and the C of Gravity and Cat are just like, they have stars in the middle.
I see it, yeah. So, like, does this guy seem like VVVVVV and thought, yeah, that's cool. So let's take out all, like, the personality.
I kind of want to play VVVV, but also it looks hard.
It's really fun. I like it a lot, but it is challenging. But I did it in one sitting.
Yeah, it's not a super long game.
That's good.
Like, probably, and most of the difficulty is just like getting the trinkets, which are optional things. So.
Like, there are a few points where, like, I was just sort of butting my head for like maybe 5-10 minutes.
I guess it can't be any worse than the Thomas Was Alone DLC, and I got through that. Don't play the Thomas Was Alone DLC, it's a lot worse than Thomas Was Alone.
I didn't even make it through Thomas Was Alone.
I love the game, but the final chapter DLC was less good.
I'd met Mike Bithell once, actually.
Have you?
Yeah.
I follow him on Twitter, he seems like a nice bloke.
He's a cool guy, but I met him once, and I'd actually reviewed Volume.
Really?
Yeah, I gave it a 7 out of 10.
Oh.
I talked to him about it, he's like, what did you review it? What did you give it? I was like, I gave it a 7 out of 10. He said, yeah, that's about right. So he was just very happy that Volume had 1 point more than Thomas Was Alone on Metacritic.
Oh.
Slow but steady improvement.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Please don't ice blast me.
Also, Undertale's on sale.
For $7 instead of $10.
You know what? What the problem with this party comp is? None of my characters who can do Resurrection are here. Whoops!
No resurrection items?
Resurrection items are incredibly expensive in this game.
Like, it would probably cover half the cost of a new item, like a new equipment item instead.
Not quite that much, but it's pretty bad.
Where I am.
Yeah.
Is there something about, like, old RPGs that just really don't want you to die?
Well, Dragon Quest was like the progenitor, and Dragon Quest 1 is a single character party. So if you die, you just die.
Yeah. But in every Dragon Quest, dying is a nightmare.
Can I still frog when the frog is dead? This is an important question. I can still frog when the frog is dead.
I say dying in Dragon Quest is actually a nightmare, but there's no game over in that game.
Yeah, it just cuts your money in half and takes you the last point you saved.
Yeah, or in later games where there is a bank, it just cuts the money you have to hand.
I'm gonna run away from this one.
Oh boy.
Hopefully. Oh shit. Maybe I'm not gonna run away from this one. this will be a problem. Oh, I got away. Thankfully, I think this is where I'm supposed to be going. And it has a save statue.
Yeah.
So I can change my party. And also a really tiny house.
Okay, I need to figure out what I'm gonna do with like my afternoon. Because I beat Doom. I don't want to play Dark Souls or Dark Souls 2 anymore.
You can play Breath of Fire.
Yeah, that's probably gonna be it.
Small child, please let me speak to your father. So I could go to Whale Cave. This doesn't seem like a good idea in my current condition. Nope. Tapeter Bosch. No, it isn't, okay. Tapeter Bosch and Nina. Oh, yeah, because I went into the... Oh, no, hang on. No, they haven't healed. That's annoying.
Can't believe I thought it was going to be Trails on the Sky SC this month. And then everything happened all at once.
I mean, I'm probably going to get back into Trails in the Sky at some point, because I did start that, so I should finish it.
I would suggest finishing something else first, like Cold Steel, since you're already into that.
Yeah, no, I was going to do that, of course. But I'm just thinking a Clan of Attack. Maybe, I don't know, Pirate... Tokyo Mirage Sessions, I'm like 15 hours into that already. Or Fire Emblem Fates, because I'm like 8 hours into that. And again, I can't just do Fire Emblem Fates anyway because of commute.
It's usually what handheld games are good for. Damn it. That was the wrong enemy.
I'm gonna be off and get myself ready to bed. So
okay.
You guys have a good night.
Good night.
Have a nice afternoon, Devon.
Yeah.
Right. See ya.
Sleep well.
See ya.
Catch-up leveling is quite satisfying in this game.
Put all my money in the bank and probably go get my ass kicked by things in the well.
Possibly. I mean, the trick with the well is you have to do the boss first, which is a bit rough. Curse me in the first encounter out the gate, oh my god. Not that I know what curse does.
Okay, well, I just annihilated that forced first enemy in one turn.
That's promising. And I definitely want Nina. Let's take Bosch and Rat. Because then I've got plenty of HP to play with. Oh, and I should save.
Lynn, why do you, don't you have fucking the AP to use any of your fucking spells, you goofball?
She's still in that state for me, by the way. Like, almost...
Incredible.
Hopefully approaching halfway through the game. Well.
Ryu's being controlled. And he hit himself. Great.
He'll do that. Okay, this cave is definitely the actual stomach of an actual whale.
Nasty.
Why can only Lynn break this gate and not, like, any other party member? I don't want to bring Lynn down here. Dadgummit.
Fire breath. Welcome to die.
So apparently Lynn's map skill is break stuff. Oh my god! So I fell into this room, and an old man turned around and went, "Ah, it's raining men! And other things!" Fucking fan translations. And there's a pair of dolphins that are called Poe and Sidon.
Maybe Jolt will be super effective on this guy. Nope. That is probably a dead monkey. Whoop, nope. 4 HP. Deathblow! Action failed. Good.
Well, that was extremely odd.
Let's see how clutch this boss fight's gonna be.
Good luck.
That's a dead monkey.
Thank you. Oh man, I'm not doing a lot of damage to these. Also, Lin is on 1 health. How is Lin on 1 health? When did that happen?
Same. Lin is also at 1 health for me. And Ryu's on 13, and everyone else is dead. Now everyone except Lin is dead. Yes. Clutch. Let's fucking win this boss fight. Spirit Wave!
Fuck me, this enemy just healed for 100 damage.
And I just lost.
Rip.
Well, whatever. Because I put all my money in the bank, I didn't lose anything. I'll just grind a bit.
I hate that there's no defend command.
There should be.
Is there?
Hit L or R when you're on the command menu.
Ah, there it is.
I forget which one it is.
Yeah, it's on. It's a weird place to hide it.
Yeah, a little bit.
Now, about that healing. Well, that's a fire weakness. I'm not sure what these things on the floor are. They look like eggs, but also we're in the belly of a whale, so probably not.
I love not being able to do anything because two enemies targeted Nita and Builder immediately.
Yikes.
Good encounter. Back to the inn.
Yeah, there's no actual urgency there that I could identify anyway.
Yep. I appreciate there's no, like, revival fee.
Yeah. So having started out with spells that require 20 and 17 AP, while her max AP is 8, Lynn has just got a spell that requires 30 AP.
Wow, she still only has 9 max AP for you, huh?
That's
fascinating.
Uh-huh. It's one way of putting it.
5 levels ahead of me, I think. I'm like level 13.
Yeah, I'm 18, 17 for my actual party leaders.
I just love that there's no, like, spell that I have access to, because they don't have Bosh to get rid of fucking poison.
Mm-hmm. Or Rand, for that matter, at that point.
I haven't met Rand yet.
You haven't even met Rand? Oh, okay. You'll get Rand for a bit. He's okay. But then they take him away from you as well. And your main healer becomes Ryu for a long time. Don't fucking rejuvenate, you piece of shit. Enemies, like regular encounter enemies that can heal for almost their entire health.
This sure is an SNES RPG.
At least they give quite a lot of XP. Hustler. These guys seem intriguing. There is supposed to be an enemy in this dungeon that's like a gold shadow type deal for XP, but definitely not that one.
God damn it. They killed Nina again.
Ugh.
Lynn has a taunt move, but she's like the not tanky at all.
Yeah.
None of the characters so far can take a fucking hit.
Yep.
I think there's gonna be a character that can take a hit either. They're just all gonna be DPS and everything is going to be terrible.
Rand is tanky. Like, he's a level below Ryu and has 60 more HP or something?
Oh,
at my level?
Rand is the beefy horseman.
Yes.
I have met Rand. I'm spacing on him.
Yeah. Oh shit! That just one-shot Ryu. Fuck. I can get him back this time at least, but yikes.
Pow, 109 damage, Jesus.
Earthshaker. Okay, that was an absurd amount of experience. That's like 300 XP per character, per party member, from a single enemy that went down in 3 hits. I don't understand how XP is calculated in this game.
Yeah, the XP curve is kind of a clusterfuck, because like, this was... This is a game that divides all the EXP games between the party members that are alive, and also all of the party members only gain experience when they're in the party.
Yep.
Which means that when they're out of the party for long stretches of time for story reasons, they don't level up.
Mm-hmm.
And that means they all have their own separate, distinct experience curves for some god-awful reason.
Sten levels up so much quicker than anyone else. So, stupid fucking monkey! But at least that helps with the whole him having a 1v1 at some point that you need to have him leveled for.
Yeah.
I'm not looking forward to that. Stamina up. What the heck is that? Oh, it's a ceiling of some sort.
Holy shit, what? What are these enemies? Handy fungus?
Uh-huh.
It's just a tiny mass of hands.
Yep.
I'm gonna light these things on fire.
Oh, Jesus.
Double damage from flare.
That sure is 50 plus damage on every party member.
Nice.
By which I mean, fuck!
Len, why are you leveling up so much? You're level 14. Sten's not even level 13. You crazy cat.
That's pretty much her character in a nutshell. Don't do this at no. Oh, thank God. It was going to cast the same lightning spell, but it didn't have enough AP.
Thank
fuck
God
me.
Monsters obeying the rules.
Yep.
I love when I get poison breath and my entire party gets hit with poison, so it's cheaper to just go to the inn than to pay for antidotes.
I can't go anywhere in this area because there are pustules in the way. Okay. Why am I fighting land lizards in the fucking whale's stomach? What naming convention produces that? Also, please don't oh shit, please don't assassinate my healer. Sorry, she's not even my healer, but she isn't the one who's got my res spell. Shit, my only available res at the moment only works in battle, and I'm about to end this battle. Yep.
Yep.
Rip. What did I just learn? Smoke.
That is probably a reduction of random encounters.
Yep. But it looks like I can only use it in battle.
What?
I may have misunderstood, but that's what it looked like. Please don't take a million turns to hit.
I wonder if I skip all the garbage going down the second time. Nope. You have to rewatch the cutscene. Or a different cutscene. Oh, no. This is... son of a bitch. I hate this well. At least I know how much HP this fucking thing has.
Helps. Right, now please don't kill the lizard. Damn it. You only get counters reliably when you don't want them.
Yep.
Or criticals, even.
I just got a critical counter!
That's also a thing.
Yep.
Oh god. Oh, thank god for that.
And fight this stupid boss again.
Good luck.
Wow, that's a... I follow some good people on Twitter.
Oh?
This tweet just says, let's take a look at this BBC political analysis article. And it's just four pictures from the article with their captions, apparently.
Oh boy.
It's Boris Johnson on a tennis court, I guess? Or some sort of court, and it says meet Britain's new representative on the world stage, and he has a face.
The Bojo regularly has a face.
Then the next picture, Mr. Johnson's poem refers to a goat, that's all we're saying. And it's a picture of a goat. Dobby the House Elf presented without comment. And then Boris Johnson apologized to the boy afterward. Apparently they're looking at, there's a rookie ball involved. Oh my god. I am enjoying this tweet. Oh, thank god, the monster on the island in the grotto doesn't respawn.
Yep.
That's nice.
What do I want to do here? Time genuinely flies playing this game. I can't believe I've been at this for an hour and a half.
Yeah, that's kind of the thing I had with Dark Souls as well, because like you just kind of whittle away time by doing minute things that just kind of add up. I have no idea. Fucking, let's try and lower this fucker's attack some more.
Good luck. Dang it, I needed better damage. Oh, don't! You! No! Don't heal each other! Oh my god!
Oh yeah, Lin dodged that fucking earthquake. That's some bullshit.
That's some dodging.
Yeah, a little bit.
This shaking planet failed to connect with me. Haha. Fuck off with the healing! Just... no!
Fuck it. Status effect things are not worth the effort and AP. Time to just punch this guy in the face with magic. Please do not kill Nina. Okay, Nina is so beyond dead. Oh my god, she has 2 HP.
Nice.
Fucking nice. Okay, heal.
Power food. What does power food do?
Yeah, just pretend to be dead, Sten, it's fine.
Power food increases strength. I don't know if that's permanent.
Lin is being controlled. Death blow.
That really?
You.
Oh my Fuck. God. Ow.
The worst part was the margin by which she killed Ryu was like 1 HP. There was no over damage on that. Oh. Man.
Nice! Another initiative encounter. That's always good.
Wow, you can just, like, switch... You can just, like, switch formations at any time. I have no idea what any of these do. But you can just hop into different formations with L.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to know what these do so I can make use of that. Anyway, flee. Or not. Sten is being controlled. What are you gonna fucking do? Nothing. You missed. Sorry, sack of shit. You stupid fucking monkey. God damn it.
That's pretty much Sten in a nutshell. This would have been a better encounter to have the... Oh god. No, wait. Thank you. Jesus, my Nina is down to 20 AP. This dungeon's taking it out of me.
Good. Nina just, or Lynn just deathblowed herself. Sten!
Oh god, what did he do?
He got spirit waved. He's the only target left alive for him to attack. He failed to fucking kill himself.
Oh my
at
8 god.
HP. He had 8 HP and he failed to kill himself.
Dang.
I'm fucking amazed. Sten, you're bad. Earthquake. That's a dead monkey. Okay, no. I don't want to put up with this right now.
More grinding. Oh god. Too slow on HP and how low are they? Counterattack and a critical. That was a little unnecessary. Oh my god, it doesn't end. Every time one of these fuckers goes to cast a spell, I get an absolute pang of terror. But they keep not having enough AP. Dear enemies, how does it feel to be Lynn? Ah, there's a stone head. I found the boss! Hooray! Right. Please don't put my entire party to sleep on turn one. That would be really annoying.
Oh my god. So, Apparently, a 91-year-old woman is under investigation in Germany after she started filling in the blank spaces on a crossword-themed artwork, piece of artwork by an avant-garde artist in a museum. In a ballpoint pen. So...
That was the right character to wake up. Thank you, Ghost. Ryu's had three criticals in a row? Well, three criticals from three consecutive attacks, anyway. Don't put me to sleep again, you shit. Oh, fuck off.
Sleep is the worst status effect.
It's pretty bad. Everyone's asleep except Rand, who's on 4 HP. This is fine.
Incredible. Sleep is mostly the worst because it's
so
mundane that they can just toss it into whatever. Like, you can't get... At least when there's, like, weird, like, cursed shit and... other weird status effects, there's extensive reasons for it. But nope, just, you're asleep. Deal with it, fuckers.
I have to heal Nina before I can wake her up, for which it's too late. Okay. No, don't kill the character I just rezzed.
This ghost is fucking you up.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm quite underleveled.
Which means more grinding.
Yep. I was possibly a bit unlucky with, like, who it put to sleep, and also I went in a bit low on health, so I'm going to try again from save state, but... Also, we're in one of those phases where the really harsh boss has decided to stop doing any damage to me, so I'm not gaining over either.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sat here desperately trying to res Ryu and failing repeatedly. Thank you. Jesus, Ryu, wake up! No? And rip. I thought I went in underhealed. Oh, that's right. Totally gonna save scum this to see if any of my dragons are effective. But I think it's a physical boss, so. Who's gonna be put to sleep on turn one? Everyone! Ha 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 ha! Let's try that again with less falling asleep on the first fucking turn. Oh god damn it. That's more like it. Will my frost dragon do any damage? No. Hooray. Actually... Ah. It is possible to attack your own party member somehow.
Yeah, I think it's up or down. Mm-hmm. And then, like, it swaps to that mode, and then you go left or right to go back to the enemies. Kinda awkward UI, or whatever.
No! Fuck off! Ah,
well,
God.
I take it.
Just killing people before I have a chance to heal them. Really? And my red spell missed?
Invisible red spells are the worst?
It's pretty fucking bad.
The animation is ridiculous. The thing that gets me, like, I wouldn't mind if, like, you had, like, a definitely reliable res spell that cost more, and like you could risk not having it go off if you paid less AP or
it's
whatever.
Missed
but...
twice.
Ugh. Yeah, like it's just that should be like a super rare occurrence. Like something has seriously gone wrong, but twice in a row.
Right. Nope. Immediately killed again.
Ruthless.
Yeah. At least it worked that time. Actually, hang on. Way to do this. Attack with you. Spirit, you use the vitamin. Good. Item healing with the fast character does still get off ahead of the enemy, who's now going to put me all to sleep again, of course.
Is there any, like, shops that might have accessories or something that prevents sleep? I don't know.
I don't think so.
Fucking wretched.
Yep.
This is why Wild Arms sleep thing where like you can have one spell and it will just continuously wake up your party was actually innovation.
Yeah, would have been nice. How the fuck is Becky? Did the Rouse fail to wake my character? Eat shit, game.
It sure did. Holy shit. That is actually kind of incredible.
You're not wrong.
Like, it did damage, and it's ostensibly a physical act.
Uh-huh.
And the whole point is to
rouse. Unbelievable.
I need to think of an anime I want Pete to watch. Because we're doing an exchange for podcast stuff.
Yeah. Sleep times again. In fairness, I can't believe that I'm still active in this fight, but, like... also, this thing... Oh, thank Christ. It's finally over.
Did you beat it?
Yep.
Congratulations.
Oh my god. I was in that for like... 10, 12 minutes?
Yeah. It took a while. 4,600 experience. Nice.
That's not that much. That's like 4 or 5 encounters.
I mean, still, from one thing.
Well, from one boss. And basically took all my MP.
Oh.
I'm on item heals from here on out. Item heals from running away. Don't do it! Oh, thank God. I've literally got 16 total AP for my entire party, and 8 of those are on a character who can't cast any of her spells, ever. And I have an initiative attack, so I can just fuck off.
I love this. You get a free round. Use it to run away.
Seems like sound policy to me. Golden armor. That might have been useful.
Maybe.
It's a big drop in vigor. What the hell? Thank you.
What is vigor?
Fuck knows. It's a JRPG stat that isn't strength or magic or mind or defense.
Let's fucking see what the guide says about stats. Because if nothing else, they have it in order. And it'll have a corresponding explanation for something. Overview. No. Apparently, Rand gets a spell at level 24 that in the original is just called 8.0. That's something. Oh boy. Equipment FAQ. No, that's just, like, literally a list of where you can find it and where you, and who can equip it. Okay, that's not useful at all. Oh, ew. This FAQ, instead of having, like, codes to search for, it's no- Oh my god.
Oh?
Its section denotes the percentage of the way through the document that the section begins in the table of contents. Oh, that's gross. That's from 2001. Oh, no.
Oh, that was a badly timed critical. Don't like this anymore.
Combat formation is independent of both the walking order and combat order. The role of position in formation is explained. It modifies damage dealt and taken from physical attacks. So that's useful to know. Basic. Wow, this is really fucking in depth. Oh, here's four cases of what? Oh my god. It's too much. Just tell me where the fucking thing is. Wow! This has... How is... Oh, no wonder this is like fucking 300-something kilobytes. It's got algorithms for how the RNG for random battles increments. Holy shit, calm down!
Useful information.
I guess, but I just want to find out what the fuck vigor does. Thank you.
Please let me out of this dungeon.
Basic combat. Apparently it's something to do. What the fuck? Basic combat mechanics. Where the fuck is this section? Mapping, no. Basic combat mechanics.
Based on how Ryu's suddenly going last all the time, Vigor might be speed.
Yeah. The order it's assorting of Vigor ratings, the combatant with highest Vigor goes first.
Right.
And agility is... Hold on. Enemies' Vigor ratings are determined differently from party members' Vigor, since enemies don't wear equipment. In random battles, an enemy's Vigor is chosen at the beginning of the generation of the enemy to be agility plus 0 to 7 to a maximum of 511? For mandatory, like, battle to the death where you can't run away, Vigor equals agility. So...
That might have woken the whale up. I might be about to get vomited. Oh, is the whale going to be my ocean-going vehicle?
Maybe. Okay, that's...
I have to add it to Dylan's list. Yep, the whale is the boat.
Okay, so yeah, party members weight, the party members have base agility, but they have equipment which weighs them down, which lowers their vigor, and vigor is the stat that determines like directly what order they're gonna go in. Why Vigor?
Where the fuck am I now?
That's a pretty harsh cut. What?
And I don't have the frog with me, so I can't get out of the whale cape area either. Oh, I see, he's put me ashore, like, just up the coast from there.
Okay, that's...
No kidding. How destroyed are things in here? And it's called Whale Cape, so the guy who lives here has just gone, the whale is gone, so I hereby rename this place Nothing Cape. Anyway, that's been like over 2 hours, and I think it is time for me to do something else.
Yeah. Fucking Vigor, why?
It's not the biggest stretch of language ever, but I would have thought vigor was HP or something. Anyway.